Hey guys, hey, I'm Antoinette Staples and I want to thank you so much for checking out my YouTube channel this week. I hope and I pray this video is a blessing to you. So whether you're new or returning, I want to say if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting on? Make sure you hit the subscribe button down below or around this box before you leave. You'll get updates every time I post a video and I try to do that once every week. So today we're talking about knowing when to move on. Knowing when to move on. Is that already hitting home for somebody? You in a situation and you know you need to move on from it. The Lord told you it's time to leave that situation and you still in it, okay? So today we're talking about knowing when to move on. Earlier this week on my Instagram page, I posted a quote and it said something to the effect of, stop convincing yourself to stay in situations that God told you to get out of. Let me repeat that. Stop convincing yourself to stay in situations you know God told you to get out of. I don't know about anybody else, but guilty as charged, right? I've been guilty of that before. But how many times when you do that, do you live with regret? You're miserable because you're in a situation that you know you shouldn't be in. The Lord's giving you signs. He's giving you red flags. He hit you over the head. He done knocked you out some days. And you still are in that situation just because you refuse to leave. Well, why is that? Because it's comfortable for you. It's safe for you. It's a scary, big, bad world out there, right? And when we're talking about in terms of relationships, we have a fear that we won't find anybody else. I mean, if we're being honest, this dating thing ain't all it's cracked up to be. And just the getting to know you process and all of that, it can be challenging at times. So sometimes we stay in relationships just because we don't want to deal with the hassle of trying to get together with someone else or do something different. But disobedience will lead us to living an average and mediocre lifestyle. And before we know it, we will be settling. We will be settling and we won't receive God's very best for us because we refuse to do what God is calling us to do. And in most cases, it feels like you're taking a huge risk. But I'm going to say, I'm going to bet all my money on God. I don't know about you, but I'm going to bet everything that I have on the Lord. And so when God tells you to do something, you need to be willing and ready to do it. There are some times when we are out living our season in certain situations and in relationships. And so when I was looking here in the scripture, and we're going to read in Hebrews, this is Hebrews 11. And we're going to start at verse 8, and it says, by faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to go out to the place which he would receive as an inheritance. And he went out not knowing where he was going. By faith, he dwelt in the land of promise as in a foreign country, dwelling in tents with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. For he waited for the city which has foundations, whose builder and maker is God. All right. So what I loved about this scripture is we see several things, right? It says he obeyed. All right. So first things first, he obeyed a command from the Lord. And many of the times God has told us it's time for you to go. It's time for you to move on. It's time for you to do something different. And so we need to be like Abraham. That takes great faith because Abraham didn't know where he was going. He didn't know what to expect, but it says Abraham obeyed the Lord, right? Because he knew he was going to receive a promise. And so I'm saying to some of us, we've forgotten the promise of God. You've forgotten what it is that God's spoken over your life because you got so caught up in this situation and it's not even halfway what you want it to be, but you're settling, right? And so because of that, out of fear, you won't move out to go and get your inheritance. Well, I just want to remind somebody today, knowing when to move on is saying, I want to go and get what God has promised me. I want to go and receive my inheritance. That's going to require a move of faith. But then as you go on, it says he did not know where he was going. You don't need to know everywhere that you're going. I don't know about anybody else, but I can be a bit of a control freak sometimes. And I'm just like, okay, where are we going? Where are we going? Now, I do like surprises. So the Lord got me all confused, right? I like surprises, but I also want to know, where are we going? What are we doing next? What's planned? I like to have stuff organized. It's got to be like black and white for me. Like I don't deal in gray, right? And so everything has to be black and white for me. And I'm like, what are we going? Where are we doing this? Lord, I need you to tell me. I need you to speak to me. Lord, I need a whole clear vision, right? And God is like, girl, you need to close your eyes and just trust me, right? And so when I tell you to move, you need to be ready to move and do what it is that I've called you to do. Abraham moved out on faith out of obedience. He wanted to go and get his inheritance, right? And he did not know where he was going. And this is the next part that I said. It was a foreign country for him. And he went dwelling in tents, okay, with Isaac and Jacob, right? Now, here it is. It says that they had a similar promise. They were also going to be they were also going to be heirs of the same promise. And so here it is, God's spoken marriage for you, but you dating someone that's not the marrying type, all right? They not even the boyfriend type, if we want to be honest. And I'm not going to leave my men out, okay? You dating a woman, I had a friend recently speak to me, he said, it's a lot of women out there, but it's not a lot of wives, okay? And so you know that the Lord spoke to you that you're going to be married, but you dating a woman that you know isn't the marrying type. So you need to move on from that situation. You're meeting and dating people that aren't even serious about you, and you're expecting to receive the promises of God from that situation. No, you've got to be willing to go out to a foreign land, go explore and do what it is that God has called you to do. Go live this life and go do what it is that God called you to do, trusting that he shall fulfill his promise. So just like there are people getting married, and we see weddings all up and people getting engaged and all these things, and you want to be married and you want to be in relationship, but you've got to be willing to be uncomfortable for a period of time in order to receive the promise that God has for you. And so it says, for he waited for the city which has foundations, whose builder and maker is God. He waited. He was obedient, not knowing where he would go. He went in tents with Isaac and Jacob, and it was a foreign land. He got willing to be uncomfortable just for a little bit to receive the promise that the Lord had for him. And then it says, and he waited. He waited, y'all. It's not gonna happen overnight. Anybody being honest and say that the Lord is dealing with you on that waiting thing? Where's my watch? We like, Lord, okay, this waiting thing is not easy. It's nothing nice, okay? And so we're like, Lord, I don't want to wait. But we ask now, let's pray, Lord, please give me a spirit like Abraham to be obedient and move when you tell me to move, okay? I want you to help me to be trusting in you, not even knowing where I'm going, not even knowing what's next, not even knowing what you have next for me, but just being willing to go left if you tell me to go left, or right if you tell me to go right, and being willing to be uncomfortable for a season. In that season, I'm going to wait with great expectation, because I know that the promise shall come, that I'm waiting on a foundation whose maker is God, the same God who created us, right? And so we have to be encouraged in that. Don't outlast your season. As Ecclesiastes 3:1 tells us, it says, there's a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens. God is saying, time's up. Okay, there's a season for everything. Don't outlast your season. There is a time to build, right? And there's a time to tear down. There is a time to invest in some things. And there are some times that you need to withdraw, or you need to retreat, some of us, right? And so when we've been in a situation for too long, we need to make sure that we're constantly seeking the Lord. Lord, is this what you have for me? And if it's not what you have for me, give me the courage to move on so that I can do what it is that you've called me to do. You know, I love sweets. I love to eat sweets. I eat them all the time. Lord, help me, Jesus. All right, I love cupcakes and pies and all these other things, okay? So I gotta work out and run real hard, right? Because I love sweets, and the Lord's really dealing with me on that. But I like these Toll House cookies. They're like the turtle chocolate chip cookies. I don't know if anybody else tried them, but if you haven't, you ought to give them a try. I'm just saying. Anyway, so I like these chocolate chip Toll House cookies, and they are the turtle cookies. So they have like caramel inside and these pecans and all these things, and they are so yummy, delicious, right? But what I realized is you have to follow the instructions on that thing to a T, or you will burn those cookies. And it's not, I'm just saying, it's not the same when they all crispy and crunchy and stuff. You don't want no crunchy turtle cookies, okay? You just don't, especially if you're a cookie lover like me, right? You want to make sure that they are moist and soft, and they almost like melt in your mouth, right? And that's the kind of cookie that you want. But there was sometimes when I got busy and I just started doing other things, and I left them in the oven too long. And every time I left them in the oven too long, I regretted it, because those things came out burnt. And so what I'm telling you is that's just the same way with life. When you put something in the oven, and you put something in life, and you put it in for a certain amount of time, when the timer is up, when God says the time is up, you need to take those things out so you can reap the benefit of it and what it was created to do. Some relationships that we are in are only there for a certain purpose, for a certain season, and for a certain reason. And when the time is up, it no longer serves us a purpose anymore. You have to be willing to move on. And that is not just in relationships with men and women. That is our friendships or anything else, right? So we have to think about that. Lord, what are you saying to me in this time? in this season and in this relationship. You've got to be willing to move when the Lord tells you to move. Like Abraham, being obedient, not knowing where you will go, all right? Being willing to be uncomfortable in a foreign land, in an unfamiliar space. When God is calling you to do something, it's going to be calling you to an unfamiliar space. Excuse me, are you willing? Are you willing to do whatever the Lord calls you to do, knowing that you shall inherit whatever it is, the promises that God has spoken over your life? You know, I watched a video for her from her a long time ago, and she said that she had an ex-boyfriend, and when she decided that that relationship was over, she threw away and trashed everything that he ever gave her because she wanted to eliminate all of those ties. And at the time, I was like, girl, you're just doing too much. You know, that's too extreme. I don't know that there's something necessary for that. I don't know that there's a reason for it. And it was so funny because God showed me that there was so much value in what she was saying. There was so much value in what she was saying because ultimately what she was saying is that you have to cut your ties. You have to cut any connection to you and anything from your past that will keep you stagnant. When the Lord tells you to move on, you've got to completely release yourself from that, and you have to be willing to move forward. Whatever is going to keep you bound, whatever is going to keep you hindered, whatever is going to keep you from walking in freedom and the liberty that God has for you to go where he wants you to go, you've got to be willing to say goodbye to those things, whatever that is for you. I don't know what that is for you, but you know. And so what I want to tell you is that you need to pray about that. Lord, are there some areas in my life where I'm holding on and I'm staying in situations longer than I should? Maybe I'm out of the relationship, but I'm holding on to memories. I got pictures everywhere. I got stuff that I can see every day that's a reminder of that person. And so while I'm not physically in the relationship anymore, I'm still relationally connected to that person. Lord, help me so that I can move on, because I want the promises that you have for me. So I don't know who this speaks to, but I just want to say, you know, in my single season, you know, I'm going to start being real transparent about my single life, okay? And so for anyone else who's watching, and I think that this hits home for a lot of people, which is why people commented on my post, all right? And this is something that we all struggle with, but I just want to say, when the Lord is telling you it's time to move on, it's time to move on, okay? So I hope this video was a blessing to you. If it was, comment, let me know. I want to hear from you, okay? So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, because you are so good, so gracious, and so kind. Lord, we thank you, Lord, that you have such great big promises for us, and we thank you for the inheritance that you have in store. We pray that you would just lead us and guide us into all truth, and we pray that you would give us the courage to be obedient when you've called us to move forward. Lord, we love you now, we praise you now, and we thank you. It's in your darling son Jesus' name that we pray and ask it all. Amen. I want to thank you again for watching. I hope this was a blessing to you. And like I said, when it's time to move on, you need to get those shoes on and get to walking, okay? You don't have to know everything that you're going to do. You don't have to even know everywhere that you're going to go. But when the Lord says move, it's time to move. All right, it's time that we all put on our wings and soar.